All right, we're getting some breaking news now that this man has been elected the new Speaker of the House, Geoff Regan. He is the MP for Halifax West, a lawyer, first elected back in 2003, and a former Minister of Fisheries and Oceans. Geoff Regan has been elected the next Speaker of the House. This is a man that many people had said was the odds-on favorite going into this election. Of course, this ballot that happens, everybody in the House of Commons gets to vote. There were three Liberals that were in play and one Conservative. But we can tell you that Geoff Regan has been elected. Let's listen in for a moment here to Geoff.
This is a very humbling experience. I want to note at the beginning that it is almost 100 years since an MP from Atlantic Canada has been the Speaker of this House. We've got to get through this, folks. Come on now. I first want to send my love to my wife, Kelly, who couldn't be here today on this, our 22nd wedding anniversary. But I want to tell you how delighted I am to have my mom and dad here today. I look very much forward to working with our new Prime Minister, the other party leaders, with the House leaders, and with every member and for every member of this House. I look forward to working with you to build a positive working environment for all, where we will have, I hope, meaningful, respectful debates. My role as your Speaker is to be fair. And I want to assure you I intend to be fair and I intend to be firm. I will not tolerate heckling. We don't need it. Not tolerant. And we're not going to, and we will not tolerate unparliamentary conduct. After the fire in this building in 1916, construction began, and it took 60 years to finish the carvings on the stone on the inside of this building. And you've seen the paintings as well. When you look at those carvings, and you walk these halls, look at how many of those depict people from this country working. The toil of our citizens, the toil, think of the toil that built this place, that built our democracy. Think also, when you see the remembrances here, of the 116,000 Canadians who are buried overseas, who fought so that we could here speak freely and express our different opinions.